And welcome back. We're taking a live look at Railey Field right now. Look at these flags really blowing around. We're seeing some very windy conditions in the valley. You're also noticing it looks pretty wet on the camera. And if you take a look right now in the Sierra, you're going to be noticing a lot of rainfall as well. Here's what it looks like right now around Applegate. Rain falling 2,000 feet. We're not expecting any snow down there. Same goes for Colfax. It's all rain at this point. Crystal Springs also seeing rain. But here's where it starts to get interesting. Whitmore, it's not snowing there. It's just reduced visibility because it's pretty foggy, misty, but still raining. Kingvale, chains are going on there, but we're also not seeing anything in the way of snow. You have to go all the way up to Donner Summit to find some snowfall, and by the time you get to the other side of the mountain, it's pretty much gone. That's how small this area of snow is. In fact, if we take a look at Triple Doppler, you can see the entire valley is completely lit up with rainfall, and just look at the Sierra. You can see just that skinny band of snow that we're seeing up in the Sierra, and we'll continue to see this rain and that little bit of snow as we go through the rest of the day today and tomorrow with windy conditions expected today. Monday will be partly cloudy but dry after starting off pretty foggy. Leticia?
Thanks, David. Well, not everyone wants to go out on Valentine's Day and spend big bucks, so why not plan your own romantic dinner for two without leaving the house? We are joined by two food and wine experts. We're here now with Patty Mastracco from Railey's Something Extra magazine and Curtis Mann from Railey's talking about wine. So tell us a little bit more about how you can have all of this food on a budget here.
Well, the whole premise of this was to just have a nice, enjoyable evening at home and have a nice light meal, but still have kind of a restaurant experience where you get multiple courses. Okay. So all of these dishes are for two people, so they're all for sharing. So you can pick, we have eight, but you can pick maybe, you know, three, four, five, depending on, you know, what you want, and still have kind of a four-course meal at home.
That's nice.
Yeah.
What do we have here?
Okay, so we have some vegetarian offerings and some meat. So I would start, like, your appetizers. This is a wild mushroom and artichoke bruschetta.
That's really good.
Yes, and it's on a great piece of grainy bread with a little base of ricotta cheese. And Curtis, what would you pair with that one?
So we specifically brought the Cremant de Loire, which is a sparkling wine, nice, you know, value wine there that goes well with the mushrooms.
Which one is that? Is that this
That's
one?
That's the fouet over there.
Okay. And then what's your next dish?
The next dish is a Belgian endive, and I have it stuffed with a quinoa mixture. So it's quinoa and almonds and dried cranberries. Yeah, really light and fun. So, but the quinoa's got a little bit of bite to it, so...
Yeah, so exactly why we brought this Lully Chardonnay, because it fits both, you know, a good structure in the acid and also got a little creaminess to go against the
And how much
the
is a bottle of this wine here?
So that's right around the low 20s.
Okay, great. And your next dish here?
Okay, so in the front we have two salads. This is a fantastic Mijoule date and butternut squash salad, which I just love. The butternut squash is kind of earthy and rustic, and the dates are really sweet. And then this is our love beet salad.
Oh, so sweet.
I know, the package, it is actually called love beet, so it's perfect for Valentine's Day. So we have our date night salad and our love beet salad.
Yeah,
so these are, these are pre-cooked beets, and you just slice them and you cut them with a cookie cutter into little hearts.
They're
pre-cooked.
I know.
I'm telling you, all these are very easy to prepare, too.
So would that be a red wine or a white wine?
Yeah, you could go either way. You could go to Chardonnay, or I brought a Chianti here. Well, you know, if it's Valentine's Day, you got to get the Italian love in there.
Yes.
So so that would go really well with the beets. The Sangiovese, you're going to blend really nice into the beet flavor.
Okay. And the next dish? Yeah?
Okay, this is a stuffed squash, and it's got,
once
again, butternut squash and turnips and some kale, and then I crushed up these little crackery things called lentil snacks over the top. So, yeah, it's a little very nice light. It could be a main or it could just be a starter.
Wine.
And then, again, if we're going wine, that's a great wine to, or a great food to have with Pinot Noir.
Okay.
Or the Chardonnay will work with it, too.
Right. And the next dish, we have salmon?
We have salmon, yeah. And what it is it's crusted with Parmesan cheese and sprouted quinoa.
Yeah, it's really delicious. And then it looks like, what do we have here?
We have gnocchi, and I cooked it and then I pan seared it, so it's got a little bit of a crunch too, and I tossed it with pesto and sun-dried tomatoes, add a little parm at the end, of course, and a little bit of basil.
Okay, and the wine
And then perfectly, this one's great with the Chianti, you know, the garlic with the Italian wine, specifically this Mori Chianti's got a really nice flavor to it that blends actually both of those dishes perfectly.
And the last dish? The
last dish is a champagne chicken. So it's just a really, it's one chicken breast, so it's just enough for two, and it's cooked with asparagus and baby carrots and some fresh herbs and champagne.
Okay. And you don't have to make all of this. Again, just pick three
pick
to four
your
dishes.
Favorites. Right.
And what I love about this is all the food here, just $50. You don't have to pay $150 to go to a restaurant. So thank you so much, Patty and Curtis, for joining us so much. We hope you have a great Valentine's Day, and here are some wonderful choices if you want to stay at home. Stay with us. We have much more news at 5 p.m.
Enjoy your day.